Thank you. I don't care if it's one of you or all of you, I'm talking. Triumphal violetal pole beans, upper 6-foot trellis, sugar snap peas, crunchy edible pods. The sidewalk, my viewing stage, I could crunch down a baby round zucchini, arugula leaves still wet, shrubbery inviting, reminding me of that beanbag I've never owned. Vines snaking down my back, my shiver, my spine ringing out that awkwardness of forgetting that girl's name. I've met her once before, should I just wait to hear it again from someone else? Why waste the time waiting when these succulents need a few weeks to bloom? I'll expect to walk past again, what's my right of nom de plume? Further down the storefront entrance mat, collecting more than the concrete floor it protects. What a pleasure to see a hand, a foot, initials of a couple hardened in the concrete ground. Maybe someday I can do that. Letting a car go by, leap of faith off a 3-inch curb across the black pond to the next continent with a line of people waiting for a table for salad. My salad is still being prepared back at so-and-so Avenue within arm's reach behind a fence. Reach? Reach for what? My phone? If I call, so-and-so won't see or smell or savor the aroma through nostril stride, crack to crack, curb to curb. Wait, what was her name again? I think it's time for lunch, but I've already ate from the greenhouse of my head. Unlimited courses of meals, only shared amongst me. Wooden bowl in hand, Siddhartha, no one in the streets, curious as to what I have to offer, but I've known this. So the headphones are back in, you're not listening. Each delaying step, indecisive turn, but appropriate altitude. Follow the directions, water daily. Thank you.